Hey guys, it's Jennifer here. Welcome back to the part two of Wish Book of Laces for a design team project for Ooh La La Vintage Treasures. I wanted to share with you how I put together the binding. I'm doing the final touches of the cover here. I decided with much decision making, I decided to go ahead and use the fabric piece for the cover of the book. So I am attaching it to the book using some Beacon 3-in-1. Could use Fabri-Tac, it probably would have been better, but it worked just fine. It has similar properties, so it definitely, you know, worked out just fine. So I didn't want to, you know, you to get bored with this, but I just wanted to show you, you know, how I went ahead and covered the book. And then one side was a little bit too long, so I trimmed the corners here. And by trimming the corners, there's less bulk there at the corner. So when I go to add my papers later, it won't cause any problems. So voila! It's going to be pretty. I love that fabric. Rachel Ashwell sitting on my shelf in my craft room. It's going to be really pretty. Okay, so I found this paper in my craft room that I had picked up at Tuesday morning a while back. And I thought it matched well with the fabric. So what I decided to do was do an interior of the album that was very neutral. So I cut the papers in 6x6. So I have two 8.5x11 sheets. And this is Basil cardstock, and I am cutting two 6x6 papers, one 5x6, and then for the binding, I want to say it's 8.5x5, or 5x8.5, however you want to look at it. So I put the measurements on the back so that you can see how they are going to be placed. And there you go. Hey guys, so let's get busy on the binding. There's so many options that you can do when it comes to binding. Again, you can make this as like a, you know, just where you punch the holes in and you can attach this without having to do the whole cover. But I kind of wanted to do the cover for this so that it will look nice sitting on my shelf and I'll have a very pretty display. So with these pages, there's different bindings that you can do. So I'm just going to show you the way that I'm going to do it. This isn't my idea or anything like that. It's been around for a long time. Because of the way that we have these pages, these are the apple cores, is you're going to need something for them to go into and for them to grab on. If you wanted to do a different way than using these, or if you wanted to create your own template so you can make multiple pages, you take basically like two pages here, you glue the sides, leave the bottom open, and attach it to the hinge so you don't see the binding at all. Well, because this is going to be a little bit different, I didn't make the pages that way, we need to have something for it to stick into, which means that the binding is going to show on top here, which is fine with me. That's not going to really bother me. If you want, you can always cover it with like a washi tape or other cardstock. You can cut out pieces of cardstock that will match. Whatever you want to do. But I did make a template after trying to figure out how I was going to do it so that I can get the three pages in here evenly. And I wanted to have 3/4 of an inch spacing between the pages so that I will have enough room for the laces. Now, if you want a bigger spacing, then you will need to make your spine bigger than 3 inches. Okay, this is for a 3-inch binding with these three pages in there, okay? So you can make your book as big as you want, as little as you want. So I took 2 8.5 by 11 sheets of paper because that's what I had in this color. And I cut 2 to 6 by 6, 1 to 5 by 6. So I'm gonna eventually do something like this to cover the inside. That way I can take these papers and use them maybe as a pocket or be able to distress the edges. So what I did was I figured out the width of my spine is 3 inches. So a combination of how far apart you want your pages and the tails here will be 3 inches, okay? So I've got, this is 1.5, and then I'm gonna do 1.5. You can space it however you want to. That's just the way that I decided to come up with. Now, once I finish scoring and gluing, then this will be how my binding will be in here, and then I can cover this like this. I'm gonna use the same color for the binding so it won't be so noticeable, but this is just an example. So I have, you know, space here. I think the best thing to do is have enough space to go over this crease on the end. That way it will not lift up on you. Okay, so I took what was left over after cutting these two sheets. So I have these cut, and then this was left over from 2 8.5 by 11 sheets of paper. So I decided to go with a neutral interior like this, and then the same color for the spine. And the spine's gonna be a little bit shorter than 6 inches, which is the book, so it's gonna be 1 inch short. And that's because my pages are 5 inches. So these pages are going to sit in here, 3 pages. All right, so now that I've explained that, let's go on to creating. So here's my template. It's kind of messy, so I decided to show you over here. Okay, so I have 8.5 by 5, and I'm putting it across the 8.5 length, okay, because I want it to fit in my book like this. Okay, so then you're gonna get out your bone folder or your scoring tool, which I already took out, and we're gonna go ahead and start scoring. I will leave the scoring measurements and the interior sizes down below. We're gonna score at 2 inches. Okay. So this is the tail. I'm gonna have 2 inches on this side as well. Then to make the first set of hills and valleys, I'm gonna score at 1/4 inch, 2 1/4, I'm sorry, 2.5, 2 3/4, and 3 inches. Okay, so that's going to be where my first page is going to sit in. Then I wanna have the space. So the space between the first page and the second page is going to be 3/4 of an inch. So I'm going to go scoring from 3 to 3/4. Then I'm going to start scoring every 1/4 inch for the next page. So I do score at 4, 4 1/4, 4 1/2, and 4 3/4. Okay, then another 3/4 of an inch. That will give me space between my pages, so that will be 5.5. Now for my third page, I'm gonna score every 1/4 inch here. So 5 3/4, 6, 6 1/4, and 6.5. And that leaves me a 2-inch tail. So I've got 2-inch tails on this outer edge,
These will be my 3 pages, and then I have the 3/4 of an inch space between. Okay, so now I'm going to show you how to fold these.
Okay. So now that we have our scoring done, we're going to fold. All right. So obviously, this is my ugly template, so I apologize. But this is so you can see. I was trying to figure out the sizes. I was only going to do a 1/2 inch tail, but I changed my mind. You can always cut off extra if you don't want these this long. But I wasn't sure how far I wanted to put it in the book, so I just decided to make the tails like that. So that's going to be folded up, and then you're going to just start folding your valleys, right? Valleys and hills. All right, so the next thing is going to be folded down, the next score line. I'm going to fold that down, right? Okay. Okay, so now we have our first peak there, right? So now we have to make another peak. So this one is going to come up. Okay. And then this one, I'm gonna fold like that. So now we have our first peak right there. Right, so now we can stick this page like that. Okay, so now you kind of get the idea where you have your 3/4 of an inch space here, and then these lines are here to make your hills and valley, and the same with this one. Okay, so here we go again. So now we've made the second page, the second valley there, so I can put my second page in, and then we'll do the same for this one. All right, so now I've got my binding all set. Okay, now we have to use some, you can use regular glue. You can use your, you know, like if you have the Beacon 3-in-1, or if you have other wet glue of choice, or you can use score tape or other kind of paper. So these have to glue together, right? Which means that I need to glue, put my score tape on one side and then glue those together. And then these two have to glue together. So on this side, I would have to glue that together, okay? I'll do one and then you can, again, this is for the people that have not made these kind of books, and just wanted to help them out a little bit. I'm sure there are a lot of seasoned bookmakers, which I am not a seasoned bookmaker, but I have made several mini albums. In fact, I actually started doing that a long time ago, so it has been quite a while since I've made a mini album. I think the last one was for my sister's baby, my nephew. All right, so I will take the, if I take the tape off of this one, then I can glue this together, okay? So I have my first peak right there, okay? And now I'm gonna make my second peak. So it doesn't matter which one of these you put the tape on. Just make sure that it's inside the score line, just right inside the score line. That way the glue isn't sticking out. Although that probably won't really matter anyway because we're gonna glue this down to the binding. Okay. So. I don't have my bone folder up here. Can you tell? That's okay. So now I'm gonna push this together to glue that together. Okay, so now this is where we're at. We have one of the I don't know what you call these, peaks and valleys, so you can, one of the valleys here, so we can put the page in, and bam, it's gonna go back and forth. Okay, so that is what we're gonna glue our pages into, and this is all stuck back here now, again. Okay, so the next step that I'm going to do is I'm going to glue this part inside. I want to have some overlap so that I can have space for this to bend. Okay? So I am going to use, I'm going to try to get that in the center there. Obviously, I want it on this side, so I'm going to glue on this side. Okay. I'm gonna put the glue right down, or this glue on here, so I don't have anything lifting. It's gonna bother me otherwise. Alright, so I want to get this in the middle as much as possible and have it as straight as possible.
then I want to add this so that I can take my pages and then glue them over top. So now I will glue this in here. Okay. You want to be careful to make sure that this is straight on the bottom and the top. Otherwise your pages will be crooked. I may take an eighth of an inch off so that doesn't interfere with this. I think that's what I'm going to do. Okay, so now I'm just adding some of this score tape to the back of my binding. I wanted to show you how I did it. I actually wanted to cover the areas of where the paper was going to slide into. That way I wouldn't have any lifting. So and I'm going to be adding a little bit of this to the inside of where the pages will slip into. And I overlapped it a little bit. That way it would be on both sides. I'm just removing the backing of the score tape now, and I'm going to add some extra because I decided I didn't add enough and I wanted to make sure that nothing lifted up. So now I'm just making sure it's straight and even. And then here is where I'm taking off. I actually ended up taking off an eighth of an inch, not a 16th. I decided to take the full eighth of an inch. That way, make sure it wouldn't get caught in where the bending of the book would occur. And I added some wet glue here as well. This is the Beacon 3-in-1. I think that looks so nice with the neutral interior here. And I can add some pockets later. I think it's going to turn out really nice. Now I'm going to slip in the pages of the album right into the slots here and make sure that they stay. And you can see I have 3/4 of an inch in between each page and before and after each page, equaling 3 inches of the spine. So that will give me plenty of room if I need to add really thick laces or if I want to put a lot of yardage on there. Well, guys, I hope that you are able to create your album from, you know, some of these tips. And thank you guys so much for watching. And I will have a final part with the embellishments and the pockets. So see you soon. Bye for now.